Are you ready?
Hey peeps, how's it going? Welcome back. A lot of you guys digged the WWE Detroit Drew versus Tom Gorse match I dropped yesterday, in case you did not see it. Here's how it ended.
Stone Cold into the cover with the title on the line.
New champion, new champion.
Two, three. The feedback from it was great. I'm not going to lie. I did not expect it to do... I didn't expect as many people to watch it, but it was awesome, you know? I had fun doing it, and it's just something that popped in my head. I already uploaded, I recorded that and edited that all yesterday. A lot of you guys loved it. Some of you guys want some more. So, here's my next question for you. If you guys want to see Detroit Drew in the ring again, putting his belt on the line, tell me who you want Detroit Drew to face next, and I'll see what I can do. With that being said... let's get back to business, man. Let's talk some Detroit Pistons. Let's talk Blake Griffin, because since he's been hurt, we have not talked about him as much because he's been out. Season-ending knee injury, surgery, whatever you want to call it. More than likely, he's not coming back this season. There's no point in the Pistons to bring him back, even if he's medically cleared to play. Let this dude heal. Now, there are a few options the Detroit Pistons can do with Blake Griffin. Option number one is keep him. I believe after this season, he does have a player option. And the Pistons are probably not going to want to pay him that. But they could keep him and take that risk, depending on how healthy he looks. That is option number one, and it's the least likely scenario. With the Pistons going away, trading Andre Drummond to Cleveland, it's more likely that they are going to trade Blake Griffin. Now, there's a couple of times that they can do it. Option number one is the offseason slash draft period. I'm going to do a video talking about this a little bit more in depth, that the Pistons could have a real shot, depending on how poorly they finish the season, at landing a top five pick. Depending on how the lottery was going to work out, the Pistons might have a shot at that. So now, depending on how much the Pistons like certain prospects, which as the season goes continuing down, we will talk more about people that I like, people that I'm going to be scouting and looking into and watching film on. I wish I could live stream so we could do it together, but we'll talk more about that when the time comes. But for right now, the Pistons could be looking at this thing. Say they get the 6th, 5th pick, somewhere around that ballpark. If they want to move up, if Blake Griffin's healthy, you package that first and you package Blake Griffin. You'll probably have to throw somebody else in there because they don't want the contract, but if he's healthy, people would want Blake Griffin. I'm not saying it's a likely scenario. It's just an option. You know, right now, we don't know who is going to be drafting where because of the lottery. But that is an option where we could package our first round draft pick, package Blake Griffin, and get something back. Move up, whatever we wanted to do with it. You know, I'll let as defense get Dwayne Casey worry about it. And it's probably going to depend on where we land. You know, if we get a top four pick or we're right where we want to be, we probably won't trade. We'll probably keep it right where we're at, keep Blake Griffin and drop that player. But if there's a player like, for example, the popular one's LaMelo. If we want LaMelo at number two or number one, wherever he's going to go, you can try to package those and move on up. Now, the other scenario that I think is the most likely possible scenario, and it's probably going to be the best for the Detroit Pistons, it's going to be a gamble, though. Okay, because we know how injury-prone Blake Griffin is. Unfortunately, I wish he was healthy. We would not be in this predicament right now. But if he comes back healthy, we know he's going to ball. Blake Griffin, when he is healthy, is an offensive juggernaut. And without probably Reggie Jackson, don't know if he'll be back, without Andre Drummond, a lot of the offense is going to go back through Blake Griffin. It's probably going to hurt Christian Wood and Thon Maker, since they're playing really well right now. Yes, Thon Maker. It's going to probably hurt Sekou a little bit when you give Blake the iso ball. Point being, though, is you kind of need that. Listen to me, because I am a strong adversary against Blake Paul. But the Pistons need him to do well next season, so that way, come trade deadline, his value is back up. Now, I don't know what people would offer for Blake Griffin, but he was third-team All-NBA last season. He was an All-Star last season. He scored 25-plus points last season, 7 rebounds and like 4 or 5 assists, somewhere around that ballpark. I mean, Blake Griffin could do a little bit of everything. And for a team that's out there, that's kind of middle of the pack, that's looking to get over the hump in the East, Milwaukee will probably be dominant again next year without even going into free agency out West. You know, the Lakers and the Clippers are already going to be good because it's LA. They'll be able to get free agents to pick up whoever they lose. It's the other teams that are going to be searching for Blake Griffin. Someone that can come in there and be a second or even third option, depending on whoever they have on the team. You can easily get a first-round draft pick for Blake Griffin because he's an expiring deal, probably with the player option, so people are kind of willing to take that gamble a little bit more. Plus, if he's healthy and he's balling, people are going to look at that like, okay, if we get Blake Griffin and he's scoring, say, 20 points a game, just 20, people will need that 20 points per game. Now, I don't know who would be available next year. I mean, that's a whole another year to look forward to. But, I mean, those are really the three options of the Blake Griffin. You know, you can either keep him, which I don't think the Pistons want to. I think they'll find him a new home. You can trade him in the offseason or trade him at the deadline next year if he's healthy. But he has to be healthy for any of those trades to work. If not, you're kind of stuck with him. So it's going to be very interesting to see what's going to happen with Blake Griffin and all that stuff. So it's something that we're going to keep our eye on to. But if we play our cards right, we will get more than Henson, Brennan Knight, and a second-round draft pick for Blake. You know, it's just the only thing that hurts Blake, besides the injuries, is his contract. That's the only reason we have not been able to move Blake, I think, for the main reason. Plus, you know, the injuries do play a factor in it. So, I mean, it's going to be a gamble, and we probably are not going to get a Tobias in a first-round draft pick, which is what we gave up for him. So, I've already been kind of prepared to see us get less return for Blake Griffin than what we gave up. But if you don't want any big contracts and you want to start over, you have to move Blake Griffin. So, not saying that I like it, but I'm at peace with it. And if we're going to do this thing, let's do this thing right. So, we'll have to stay tuned. And, you know, that leaves the question with, what do we do with Derrick Rose? Probably the same thing. So, we'll have to keep our eyes open, listen to everything that's going on. Pistons will probably be sellers for a few years. So, we'll see. We'll certainly see. Hopefully, we can get a good draft pick. I'll be probably talking about that tomorrow. But, yeah. Pistons are in rebuild. So, leave it down in the comment section. What do you guys want to do with Blake? Instagram, Twitter, DSM members in the description. Above the Rim, Saturday on JMO's channel. I am not sure what time it is because I have to work Saturday. I don't get out until 2. So, we'll have to wait and see what time that's going to be. But it's going to be on JMO's channel again. But I'll see you guys tomorrow. Peace.